In the medical field, what we focus on, of course, is those things that are prescription or over-the-counter medications. These things have a lot of side effects. They're not always effective. A doctor like myself really loves not only conventional medicine, which is surgery, drugs, and prescriptions and all that, but I love those things that are natural healing substances from the earth, the way God created wonderful substances in the Bible, the yield of the land for good health. In the medical field, it's wonderful to know about these things as well. And I want to share a few of these things with you right now based on some of the questions that you all are answering. For example, I've had questions about herbs for weight loss. There are many things that can actually help weight loss besides herbs, but I do want to mention a few things from the plant-based side. Some are herbs, some are more plant-based food substances that we kind of put in with the botanical medicine, the herbal remedies. One of the things that's very important for losing weight is to stimulate your metabolism. We really want to help you be faster calorie burners. If you want to take off weight and you don't want to have weight that just keeps accumulating and accumulating, that's what we see with a slow metabolism. And again, it's very common in doing both medicine, as I did, and then ministry, that both men and women will come to me wanting to know how to get into balance. Women who come saying that they really need to take off weight and that they're accumulating pounds. Sometimes this happens just with changes in our life, like women who've been through pregnancy. Often they'll find that it's difficult to take off that last 10 or 15 or 20 pounds, depending on how much weight they gain during pregnancy. A lot of women find that after they go through the change or menopause, that they start to put weight on and they get really frustrated. They say, I just put on 10 or 15 pounds this year, and every year after menopause, I'm putting on more weight and more weight. And they also find other things we see after the menopause change that I've seen as a doctor. Cholesterol goes up, blood pressure can go up, and women who've never had these issues all of a sudden say, I'm so frustrated, all of a sudden my doctor's telling me I'm at heart attack risk. So weight gain is just one of those things that can happen either after pregnancy, after menopause. It can happen when you're under a lot of stress. You go to a more sedentary lifestyle and you're no longer exercising, because exercise helps you burn calories. So let's start with a few of these things beside the herbs that are obviously good for burning calories. And one thing that Dr. Malou loves that I'm a big fan of too is the benefit of exercise. And exercise can be more fancy and complicated, like workout programs and special programs that you do in the gym with weights or different kinds of programs. But also just simple things like walking, bike riding, those things that are moderate aerobic exercise really helps you burn calories. It helps balance your mood. You're oxygenating better when you're moving. It is crucial. Not only does it help you take weight off, but it helps you have more energy, more strength, healthier brain function. It brings circulation to your brain and the rest of your body. So God meant us to move and not meant us to sit at our computers 24/7 or just watch television or sit there with our fast food. On top of that, you want to be careful with your diet. You don't want to take in foods that accumulate pounds and also make you unhealthy and put you at a higher risk of diseases, even like cancer and heart disease, which would be foods like eating way too much sugar or having too much alcohol in your diet, which can damage your liver, it can damage your heart, it damages your brain. You want to be careful with too much fast food because it tastes incredible, but it lacks nutrients. You're getting everything, synthetic chemicals, high fat, high sugar, high refined carbohydrate, but you're not getting a lot of nutrients. You have to be careful with that. You can also add supplements that can be very, very helpful for your dietary needs. And these are kind of cover some of the questions that you all have asked. A couple of things that are very helpful would be just to stimulate your adrenals and your brain chemicals that help you burn calories, that are more efficient in terms of not only taking off weight, but just giving you energy. And there are certain nutrients that are non-herbal, but that are very helpful for both endocrine support, like adrenals, and also brain support. And these are common things you can get in a really good multivitamin, but you may even want to supplement and take a little bit of extra. For example, a good multivitamin, multimineral, you want to have one with enough B vitamins. And that can be as much as, you know, a B50, where it's 50 milligrams of B1, 50 of B2, you know, down the line, 50 of B6, on and on and on. And that can be very helpful. And again, magnesium in the diet is very good for your brain. It's very good for female hormones. Vitamin C is anti-inflammatory. It helps support not only your brain function, but your adrenals. And the adrenal glands are really important if you want to not only lose weight and have a more speedy metabolism, but if you want healthy energy, reduce inflammation, have healthier heart, healthier blood pressure, regulate against being diabetic. So it's really important to have strong, healthy adrenals. And there are some nutrients that are very helpful to support your adrenals. One would be rhodiola rosea, which is a very good herb that's very helpful for a healthy, strong adrenal function. And it's an herb that's been around for a while. And when I was working with vitamin companies that wanted me to help formulate products for them, rhodiola was an herb that was getting to be more and more popular. There are certain kinds of ginseng that are more appropriate for women. For example, Korean red ginseng is really a man's ginseng. It helps to make men really high functioning in terms of energy and drive and male hormone levels. And men feel like they could take on the world. You know, they feel strong and full of male drive. And so it's a great herb for men. Women, it's terrible. It gives you energy, but it dries up your menstrual cycles. You literally just can stop having menstruation because it's really meant for the male hormone, the male body. Now, there are American ginsengs and also some of the Chinese ginsengs that are more suited for the female body. And a good product will support your endocrine system in the brain, your thyroid, your adrenals. And not only will that give you a good mood, but it also can be very balancing for your weight, your endocrine function. So these can be other kinds of plant substances that can be very useful. Saffron is used also in some products to help with weight loss. And you've all had saffron if you've eaten Spanish food like paella. It's what's used to flavor it, but it's a very good herb also for women in the menopause, because it can reduce menopause symptoms just a tiniest little bit, like 1/10 of a teaspoon, just literally a few little strands. So you can get these things in the health food stores. You can get them online. Green tea extract has some interesting research where if you have the equivalent of 3 cups of green tea a day, which, by the way, is very low in caffeine, but has a little bit, it can be very helpful in terms of weight loss. And I've actually worked with some vitamin companies to work with them in terms of the research where they've been very interested in green tea as part of a nutritional program. Green coffee extract can be helpful. Some of these products are actually more to the high caffeine side. A lot of people, of course, like their cup or two of coffee in the morning to get them going and give them energy. And of course, that's the caffeine, which acts like a natural stimulant. And a cup or two of coffee a day is okay. It really won't hurt you. You start to get up into problems when you really drink a lot of coffee. Some people I've seen as patients, they come in, they're drinking 8, 10, 12 cups of coffee a day. And if they don't use coffee, they get withdrawal headaches and they get a lot of symptoms. So everything is balance in life. You just want to have the good, healthy balance so that you are taking in the right amount, the healthy amount of everything. But the teas and a little bit of caffeine, healthy amount of something like, you know, caffeinated beverage like coffee can be very helpful again for just giving you a higher metabolism. One thing that is not a vitamin or a mineral or a supplement that can be very helpful are some of the medical devices that more and more research is being done on. For example, one is a red light LED therapy device. There's a lot of uses. NASA has actually researched red light for wound healing in astronauts. Isn't that interesting? And there's a lot of really interesting research on red light lasers, but those things cost thousands and thousands of dollars, but they have a lot of therapeutic benefits. You can literally get a very inexpensive red light device, and with infrared, it actually reduces pain. Red light infrared devices are very good with pain. Red light is a stimulant. Some of the really interesting research on it, well, they're from research studies all over the world. Like red light stimulates the mitochondria of the cells and literally stimulates a chemical called CoQ10. That's an amazing chemical because it gives you energy, it gives you strength. It can be very helpful. It stimulates your circulation, It brightens your mood. It makes you more joyful, more happy. And an expensive red light therapy device can be helpful. You can get these things for under $100, like even $60, if you're interested in that sort of thing. So I'm just mentioning it because I'm trying to mention a variety of substances, exercise, diet, even devices that can be helpful for not only weight, but just balancing your metabolism, balancing your brain, giving you strength, giving you energy. I did have a question on B17. That is another one of these nutrients that in alternative medicine is used for cancer therapy. The American medical societies, which don't particularly like integrative medicine in general, aren't fond of this kind of supplement. It's not encouraged here in our country. Cancer therapy hospitals, cancer therapy clinics in other countries do sometimes use this substance, which is food derived. It's something to be aware of, that's one of the main uses for it. Conventional regular medicine, which both Dr. Malou and I are part of from our background training, frowns on this sort of thing, as they often frown on the use of vitamins and minerals instead of drugs. I think there's definitely a place for medication and drugs. There's no question. If you're in the ICU and you've just been in a car crash and somebody's head-on crashed into you and you've had injury, of course, it's going to be really helpful. You're going to be on IVs, you're going to be on medications, all kinds of things. If you had strokes or heart attacks. But in the long run, if you have a chronic illness, the two things that are absolutely the best to heal and to be cured is, number one, God, which is to pray to the Lord. That is number one. As a doctor and as a minister, I'm praying for people all the time and seeing the hand of the Lord create miracles. Miracles of every kind for every kind of illness. There's nothing that God can't do to heal you. We see miracles of God's healing all the time. And who's the healer? God is the healer. We're here, we're vessels for the Lord. God uses us for our medical information. He created us in the greatest detail, so He loves the medical information about how the body works. So we're vessels for the Lord, but He is the healer. The other thing that you can do yourself that you don't need a doctor for is healthy living. You don't need a doctor to tell you to go take a walk or go bike ride or work out in the gym. Yeah, we can tell you to do that, but you have to do it yourself. What does He say in the Bible? God gave us life through the breath. That's right in the book of Genesis. And how do we get better breath? It's through exercise and through deep breathing, which we don't do when we're sitting at our desk or watching TV or doing computers. So healthy lifestyle. God wants us to honor His creation, and you are His creation. You're His precious creation. So He wants you to eat well and take supplements that can help restore and build you. Have positive thoughts. What are the things that God talks about in the Bible? He talks about healthy thoughts, our thinking. He's all Philippians 4:8. He wants us to think of those things that are uplifting and lovely and beautiful. And love is patient, love is kind. That's Corinthians 1:13. He wants us to love, not in a selfish, self-centered way, but He wants us to not, keep a list of wrongs. And love is patient, love is kind. He tells us how He wants us to be. He wants us to have the heart of God. He wants us to conform our minds to Him. And He blesses us. That's where God says He'll answer all of our prayers. Again, healthy living supports God's good work. And you are God's good work. Every one of you is God's good work. He loves you. He doesn't want you to be sick. He doesn't want you to have problems. I want to make that point that our thoughts are really important. Yes, in the medical field, if you're depressed, I can prescribe antidepressant medication. If you're having anxiety attacks or panic, I prescribe anti-anxiety medications. But what we want is the love of God in our hearts. And when we have a loving, caring, joyful, good heart. Remember, a merry heart is good medicine. That's when we have beautiful health. Because what happens when we chase away fear and depression and anger and resentment and irritability and judgmentalness, anxiety and abandonment and all the rest of these things that clog up our mind and our brain and our heart? Well, first of all, we have a healthier body because we're chasing away those things that make us sick and crush our body and reduce our immunity. I love to pray these things out for people and help them with healthy living, Because as we chase these things out, what does God do? He fills us with love and he fills us with his light. And God is light and God is love. Remember the Bible, in him there is no darkness. There's no shadows in God. And the more we live and we let God fill us with his love and light, all of our cells, those little building blocks of our whole body, trillions of these in our body, and they're like the bricks of a house. They're our foundation. And the more we are filled with the light and love of God, the happier we are, the healthier we are, the healthier our bodies are, the healthier our minds are, and we are blessed. I just want to pray that God fill your minds and your hearts, every cell of your body, with light and love, and that you move through your life filled with the light and love of God, and you will have a beautiful life. Amen.